Hello everyone, I'm Anjuma Datta. I'm from VIT University, Vellore. My research guide is Dr. Sunita V, and I will be presenting on the topic Laminar Airflow Chamber. So first we will see what a laminar airflow chamber is. A laminar airflow chamber is a clean bench that provides a space to work with a product or specimen where it will be protected from contamination by particulates such as microorganisms. I will show you how a laminar airflow chamber looks like. This is how it looks. It is also known as a tissue culture hood. We'll now learn a little bit about its history. Laminar airflow chamber is a fairly new innovation. The idea of a laminar airflow chamber was developed by a few scientists around early 2000s. Koek et al. Gave the basic definition of laminar airflow chamber in 2005. Laminar airflow made working in sterile conditions much easier than before, and now it is available in almost all colleges and universities which deal with biological samples. For example, it is available in VIT, in all the biological labs. Now we will understand a little about the mechanism and working of a laminar airflow chamber. The process of laminar airflow can be described as airflow where an entire body of air flows with steady uniform velocity. Laminar flow cabinets work by the use of inflow laminar air drawn through one or more HEPA filters designed to create a particle-free working environment and provide product protection. Air is taken through a filtration system and then exhausted across the work surface as part of the laminar flow's process. Commonly, the filtration system comprises of a pre-filter and a HEPA filter. The laminar flow cabinet is enclosed on the sides and constant positive air pressure is maintained to prevent the intrusion of contaminated room air. Components of laminar air flow chamber: pre-filter, blower, HEPA filter, acrylic hood, workbench, UV light, lamp, and a lid. Now we will see each of them in a little bit detail. Pre-filter and blower. Pre-filter provides efficiency of 40% by NBS test method using atmospheric dust or even better. So it basically increases the efficiency of HEPA filter. Blower provides air inside the laminar airflow chamber. So now you can see in the diagram, the blower is situated right over here. This white part is the blower, and this right here is the pre-filter. The blue part here is the pre-filter. So the air comes in from outside, gets into the pre-filter, gets filtered, goes in through the blower, gets filtered through the HEPA filter, and then comes inside the laminar airflow chamber. It is the most important part of a laminar airflow chamber. It is acronym for high efficiency particulate air. This can remove particles at least 99.7%. And it is mainly made up of borosilicate microfibers in the form of pleated sheets. So this is what a HEPA filter looks like from inside. And this is a diagrammatic sketch of a HEPA filter. There are 5 types of HEPA filter: A, B, C, D, and E, and each of them have different applications, as you can see. HEPA in laminar airflow systems. Laminar airflow systems are used for cleaning air in aseptic rooms. In laminar airflow systems, clean air is obtained through HEPA filters. The air flows at a speed of 100 feet per minute and sweeps dust particles, making entire room free of particulate matter. A very important thing to note here is that HEPA filter is extremely fragile, so it should be shipped, stored and handled very carefully. A authorized person should be there to take care of HEPA filters. If they're shipped correctly, if they're handled carefully, everything should be done by an authorized personnel only. All incoming HEPA filters should be visually inspected for any apparent problems. Acrylic hood. It is usually present at the sides of the laminar airflow chamber and it should be periodically cleaned to avoid any kind of contamination by bacteria or other dust particles from the atmosphere. Workbench. This is made of stainless steel and this is where the actual work is carried out. All the biological samples with which work has to be done are kept in here. Usually there is a burner kept inside the laminar airflow chamber on the workbench. This is there to sterilize any inoculum loop which can be used during streaking. Then there's UV light. There is a switch for UV light on top right side of the laminar airflow, which switches on the UV light inside it to kill any microbes which might have entered when the lid was opened. Lamp. There's also a switch off lamp just beside the UV light switch. This is basically there to provide visibility for the worker. Then there's a lid. The lid can be made of either plastic or glass and it separates the laminar airflow chamber workbench from the outer atmosphere. Types of laminar flow cabinets. There are two types of laminar flow cabinets. The first is the horizontal laminar flow cabinet. Horizontal laminar flow cabinets receive their name due to the direction of airflow which comes from above but then changes direction and is processed across the work in a horizontal direction. The constant flow of filtered air provides material and product protection. As you can see in the diagram, this is a horizontal hood or horizontal laminar flow cabinet. The pre-filter is situated over here, so the atmospheric air comes in through here, gets filtered, then it goes up, gets filtered by HEPA filters, then it comes back and is sent inside the laminar airflow chamber through the walls over here, which is why there is horizontal airflow, as you can see indicated by the arrows. Now the second type of laminar airflow chamber is the vertical laminar airflow cabinet. The vertical laminar airflow cabinet function equally well as horizontal laminar flow cabinets, with laminar air directed vertically downwards onto the working area. The air can leave the working area via holes in the base. Vertical flow cabinets can provide greater operator protection. In this diagram, you can see that the air is coming in through here. It is going up, getting filtered through the HEPA filter, and it finally comes down through the holes which are present at the top, and it leaves through the holes in the bottom. Laminar flow cabinets. Laminar flow cabinets create particle-free working environments by projecting air through a filtration system and exhausting it across a work surface in a laminar or unidirectional air stream. They provide an excellent clean air environment for a number of laboratory requirements. Uses of laminar airflow chamber. Laminar flow cabinets are suitable for a variety of applications and especially when an individual clean environment is required for smaller items, example, particle-sensitive electronic devices. In the lab, laminar flow cabinets are commonly used for specialized work. Laminar flow cabinets can be tailor-made to specific requirements of the lab and are also ideal for general lab work, especially in medical, pharmaceutical, electronic, and industrial sectors. How are laminar flow chambers made? Laminar flow cabinets, or laminar airflow cabinets as they are also known, are normally made of stainless steel with no gaps or joints, thereby preventing the buildup of bacteria from collecting anywhere inside the work zone, so that it does not contaminate any biological samples which are present inside it. Laminar flow cabinets are also known as clean benches because the air for working environment is thoroughly cleaned by precision filtration processes. These are the laminar flow chambers found in VIT. This one is in SMV212. This is of AirTech. And this one is found in SMV216. Company is Clean Air. Both are horizontal laminar airflow chambers. There are others also, but these are the main two types found. Now, there is a lot of confusion between biosafety cabinet and laminar airflow chamber, which I will clear in this video. So, the difference between laminar airflow chamber and biosafety cabinets is, laminar flow cabinets are normally produced to protect the working area only. They do not offer operator protection and are not suitable for working with biohazards. Whereas biosafety cabinets provide protection to product as well as the worker. So if any work has to be carried out involving biohazardous products, it should be done with biosafety cabinets and not with laminar airflow cabinets. So this was all the basics about laminar airflow cabinets. Now I will show you a practical example of how to use a laminar airflow.
Now I will explain how to work inside the laminar airflow chamber. So first we have to switch on the UV light to ensure that no germs are present inside it. After 20 minutes we can turn it off, and then we switch on the flow and the light. We open the workbench. Now just before we start working, we have to ensure that we clean it with 70% ethanol and cover it. Those samples should not be taken out of it because there might be